everyone, it's Carolina from Gotta Love Polish. Welcome back to my channel. Welcome if you're new. So in today's video, I'm going to do a quick and dirty. I say this every time, but it usually ends up being long. But I'm going to try to do a quick and dirty video of the Topic Tuesday for the week of January 23rd. So the Topic Tuesday for this week is basically shopping your stash to find if you have any of the colors that would match the color of the year, which if you don't know is Peach Fuzz. I'm going to read out loud the description that Pantone has put out for Peach Fuzz. And Peach Fuzz is subtly sensual. Pantone Peach Fuzz is a heartfelt peach hue, bringing a feeling of kindness and tenderness, communicating a message of caring and sharing, community and collaboration. A warm and cozy shade highlighting our desire for togetherness with others or for enjoying a moment of stillness and the feeling of sanctuary. Their message, I'm all for. I love this message. I love that they're trying to evoke these feelings with a color. But I'm gonna have to respectfully disagree that I think that this color is it. Now, don't get me wrong. I actually love the color peach. I think it's beautiful. I'm always attracted to it, but it tends to look horrible on me, like horrible. However, that being said, I actually have some peaches left in my collection or tones that are peach-like. They may not be strictly a peach color, but they're peach-like. The cool thing about Pantone is that they actually give you a variety of shades to go with the color that they choose for the year. So I went through their website and I looked at the shades of peach, and there are a couple of more pink leaning peach, which to me, that's usually what peach is. It's like peachy pink kind of color, but there's also a little bit of more orangey leanings. I pulled out a couple of polishes that I still have in my collection that I have actually worn, and I pulled out a couple of polishes that I have not worn yet, but I feel like can fall really well into this category. Now let's get on with the polishes. I'm going to show this polishes in no particular order. I did try to do a gradient effect from lightest to darkest, but honestly, the color is always deceiving because I did try to do this just by looking at the polish bottle. The first one up is Essie's Feeling Wellies. Feeling Wellies is a pastel yellow with red undertones, according to the Essie website. Even looking at it now, it does seem to be a little bit more yellow than the other colors that I have here. But looking at it just as a standalone, I felt that it looked very peachy. I also try to compare it to the colors on my monitor from the Pantone website, and it does lean a little bit on the peach side, but honestly, it does have a little bit more yellow than what I was thinking when I saw the colors. When I saw it in the bottle, I immediately grabbed it and thought, this is a little bit peachy, but now looking at it, I think I have chosen poorly. Next color we have here is H&M, and this is in Peach Perfect. On the H&M website, there isn't a good description for this polish. It does say it's a light pink solid color. That is literally all that I could find for this Peach Perfect from H&M. When I originally put the bottles together, I felt that Peach Perfect was a little bit darker than Feeling Wellies, but after swatching them side by side, I definitely feel that the Peach Perfect is a lighter color. It still has a little bit more yellow, not as much as Feeling Wellies. Both of these polishes have a pretty amazing formula. They're perfectly opaque at two coats. They don't look the best on me, at least I don't think they do. When I wore both of these polishes, I just did not like the way they looked at me at all. So these two, even though I still have them in my collection, they have been on the chopping block, and doing this swatch reminds me that, yeah, maybe this is not the best color for me. The following polish is pretty serious, and this is in Peachy Poo. I mostly bought this for the name and also because at the time this was such a unique color, especially because I remember it being more like a bleached neon kind of collection. If I remember correctly, I could be totally misremembering. According to the description that I found online, Peachy Poo is a pastel bright peach. It did look a little bit orangier. It could be that the person who was swatching the polish is lighter skin than me, so it does lean a little bit more orangey on them. This one definitely leans a little bit more pink compared to the other two. For me, I remember wearing this. It has been a hot minute since I've worn it, so I can't quite recall exactly how it looked on me. It wasn't one of my favorites. It was interesting because it was unique to me at the time, but I don't know. I still have it in my collection, so obviously I have some kind of sentimental attachment to it. Formula was okay. It's a little bit streaky, but I think that is mostly due to the fact that it has the skinny brushes that these used to have. I may have to actually wear this year and see how I feel about it, if I'm really ready to take this out of my collection. Next polish is Cirque Colors in Persica or Persecia. This is a pastel peach nail polish with copper specks, according to the Cirque Colors description page. This one, I always thought it was more like, I don't know, orangey leaning. I never really thought that it was a real peach-esque color because to me it always felt more like orangesicle kind of color. I don't know. Now this one, I do have a rubber band indicating that this is a unworn polish, but I'm 99.9% sure I have wore this in a Skittle manicures. However, until recently, anything that was in a Skittle manicure, I didn't consider as worn because it wasn't on a full manicure. But towards the end of 2023, I decided that that's just kind of a little bit ridiculous. I have a lot of polishes, and if I have worn them on my nail, I'm gonna count them. Since I purchased this a while ago, this does have that skinny Cirque brush that honestly I'm not a big fan of, but I also don't hate as much as other people seem to hate. I do love the speckle effect that this polish gives you. This is a great peach color in my opinion. It's not my favorite. It does look okay to me. In the bottle, I really like this color. On my nails, not so much. The next polish is an OPI, and this one is actually called Quarreling Your Spirit Animal. This is from the Mexico collection for spring some couple of years ago. I don't remember when. The description says, enjoy the spirit of a warm coral nail polish glow. I just can't with these descriptions. So yes, this does have coral in the name, and yes, it is a corally color, but I consider this a little bit more of a peachy coral, a corally peach color. So the other corals that I prefer tend to be very pink leaning. I'm thinking about Butter London in Trout Pout or Morgan Taylor in Don't Worry, Be Brilliant, even though that one is like almost neon. And those are more corally to me. And this one, even though it does say coral in the name, when I saw it in the drawer that I keep my oranges, my corals, and my peachy kind of color, I said, this looks like a good color for peach. And so I pulled it out. And I think I did have this one in the chopping block at one point, and then something made me put it back in my drawer, and now I'm kind of on the fence about it again. Now, obviously, this one is showing up a lot darker compared to the other polishes that I have swatched in the wheel already. This one is a little bit more like nudie pinky kind of color. I don't know how to explain it, but I'm pretty sure this is still available through retailers. I don't know. It just seems like a good compromise for a peach tone color, even though it's described as a coral. I did have to do a third coat for the swatch wheel since I accidentally dropped it. So you'll see it at three coats. So it does look a little bit darker than it originally did. The next polish is another indie, and this one is from Ethereal Lacquer, and this is called Dreamtide. Now, Dreamtide came out in polish pickup for 2020, and it is described as a coral pink lacquer full of red to copper shifting shimmer with a bright green shift at extreme angles. I have worn this. I've worn it at three coats, and it is beautiful. Yes, this is definitely another corally one, but I think it matches with the pinky corally tones of Peach Fuzz gradient that I saw on the Pantone website. So I'm gonna call this one as a peach-esque type color, and I have no regrets. This one is very sheer, and it does have to be worn at three coats. I do believe that it still has a little bit of visible nail line, if I remember correctly, but I could be misremembering. Regardless, this one is a peach-esque kind of color that I really enjoy. And the final polish that I'm going to talk about is an actual untried, and this is Kathleen & Co. in Mango Flamango. I don't know why that cracks me up. And this one is from the summer collection of 2021. I did purchase this during Polish and Beauty Expo back in 2021. Now, this one is described as a peach polish with pink to orange shifting shimmer. So it's right there in the name. It's peach polish. I was kind of on the fence about this one, actually. I went through my untried drawers for this one because I remembered it and it was like stuck in my head. I'm like, I have another peach polish. There actually have been two other peach polishes that I purchased within the last couple of years. They were from Wildflower Lacquer, I believe. One of them was like an I Love Lucy, and then there was another one, but I can't remember the name of it. Maybe it was a Dolly Parton one. I didn't buy that one, but I was tempted to, if I remember correctly. And I didn't buy the Dolly one because I remember I bought the Lucy one, and without even wearing it, I destashed it because just swatching it, I was just like, no, this is not for me. But this one, this Kathleen & Co. in Mango Flamango, has that pink to orange shifting shimmer in here that it warms this up in a pink tone of way, if that makes sense. It's very sheer, so I'll probably need to use three coats for this, but I have a feeling I'm gonna like this one on my nails better than most of the other ones, other than the Ethereal Lacquer, because I love that one. But I think I'm gonna enjoy it because it does have so much pink to it, and like I mentioned before, for corals, I tend to like them more peach or pink leaning as well. And I think peach colors I will like a little bit better on me, pink leaning. So the first half of this color wheel, I'm just not loving as much. And they were on the chopping block for a reason, and I should have just followed my gut and destashed them already. But I didn't, and now I'm kind of like, let me try them out. Let me give them a second chance. Who knows? I may end up liking them. Before I forget, I want to let you know what I'm wearing on my nails today. The first color is the Zombie Claw in Snow Leopard Cuddles. This is the one that I have on three nails on each hand. And I decided to pair it up with Bee's Knees Lacquer One Human Alcohol Beer, Please. I love that name. Alright, so that's it for my video for the Topic Tuesday for January 23rd. What did you all think? What were the best matches that I have in my collection? This is a really small matchup because, again, not my favorite color to wear on me, even though I do enjoy the color in general. But I was actually really surprised that I had this many to talk about because that's seven polishes of a color that I don't actually love on me. And yet I have seven polishes. Okay, so honestly, if I were to destash some of the colors right now, I feel like from here, which is Pretty Serious Cosmetic Peachy Poo, to here, which is Kathleen and Company's Mango Flamango, would be safe. These two, which is the H&M Peach Perfect and the Essie Filling Wellies, I think I can live without those in my collection. Like, for real, for real. They just don't seem to attract me at all. But wearing it on the nail wheel here, it doesn't look as bad as I thought it would. The Peach Perfect, I definitely don't love on me. That one definitely can go. But the Essie Filling Wellies, I think I can deal with that a little bit longer. Definitely enjoy the way that this Pretty Serious Cosmetics Peachy Poo looks on me. I enjoyed it when I wore it the first time. I like that one. I'm okay with that one. This one, yeah, I don't know. The Cirque colors, I'm still on the fence about. It's still prettier than the Filling Wellies, but I don't know. I don't know. We'll see. This one is the Crawfish and Four Compliment. I think I'm going to keep this one after all because I actually don't hate it right now. Maybe, you know, when your tastes change, you tend to like things that you didn't think you'd like before, and maybe that's what's happening with this one. Definitely keeping the Ethereal Lacquer Dreamtide. I love the way this looks. This is just two coats on the swatch wheel, but I do remember wearing three on my natural nail. But maybe this time when I wear it, I'll put a white blurring base coat, and maybe that'll help me just use two coats instead of three. And this is just two coats of Mango Flamango, and this one I really like a lot. It looks so pretty. Again, let me know in the comments down below if you have any of the same polishes that I do for your peach picks for your collection. I love shopping my stash. I love these Topic Tuesdays that make me think, what do I have, and hunt things down. Even though only one of these polishes is an untried, it's been so long that I honestly could not remember some of these polishes. Like, they didn't stick to me. And again, at the time, I really wasn't feeling it. So we'll see. I think I probably will get rid of a couple of polishes after this video. But I will be very interested to know, what do you have in your collection? Maybe it's something I have and I'm not thinking about it and didn't see it, so I'm not registering that it could be part of the Peach Fuzz family. I would be very interested if you leave me that comment down below. Thank you everyone so much for taking the time out of your day to watch this video. I hope you enjoy it, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.